こんにちは。
こんにちは。
May report the native project, you may find an error
the error will give you a two solution, and you just the solution two. You can try it now. You can try. Maybe you can. Do you want to try it to your laptop? If you already installed the .NET, create a web app. It's very simple. First, you make the expert web. You just create a directory where your project will be run. I will try in my I want to create my project in my directory called temp and spell nona. Okay, first I want to create my project with the name SPWeb2 and set the directory, and you just run the .NET name MPC, and the comment can generate. The comment generate all MVC of your project. You don't, if you use PHP. If you use PHP, maybe PHP with CI. Maybe you must download the CI with CI on web CI. But for the MVC, you can create scaffolding like that. The command will create the test plots, view, controller, and model. Then design your app, and I've already designed in like that. And I use a Visual Studio to make a project with the .NET language. Okay, it's Visual Studio, and I open folder. It's open, and SPWeb 2. Yes, okay. And it's my project. It's a result from a new MVC command. And you can design your apps new MVC, .NET new MVC, you can have a one controller with home. Home is a new reset with about index and contact. And the home is a generate with a about contact in index HTML too. And you can run that. And Visual Studio, you can open a terminal like a console in OpenSUSE, and you can run the .NET build to build your application. I'm sorry. Before .NET build, you must do .NET run .NET Restore. .NET Restore is to download your dependency. Dependency is this the JS approach. And then .NET run. Say no listening on localhost library. Localhost 5000. And it's a reset. And it's a reset basic from if you generate with the calcode from about and you can design your application. You can design your application like that, yes, for me. But sometimes, if you want to the application in production, it works in my laptop, it works in my box, but not in my production. And you need to call up IT admin to install all the dependency, install .NET, install another. Can say not possible. It work on my machine, but it not work in my production. Why? How to resolve that? Do you know how to resolve that? If you want to create, you want your application with the same in production, same with your app. Same with your laptop. In here, I use a Docker. What is Docker? And then a Docker is open source project. It's a documentation from Docker. Say Docker is open source project that automates the deployment. Open source project automates the deployment of application inside software container. So Docker is a great container for you, for your application, for your project. A container is a sandbox process for running an application. It's and its dependency. So if you want to run in production, you just to run the Docker, the Docker image you create. How to make a .NET application on Docker like that. Before I want to explain you what is Docker, what the difference of deployment and container. like the image. Virtual machine is have a host operating system and boost operating system. And the application run on app, the Ghost OS app 1 run on Ghost OS Green and app 2 run on Ghost OS Orange. But with Docker image, you just with Docker engine, you just install a Docker and anything application you run on a Docker image. Okay, it's a Docker hyper respect to any client. You can build, pull, and run. If you have already created a Docker image, you can pull to hook, yes. And you can run. It's a like Docker image. But you need to build a Docker image. The Docker image should contain everything to get. Remember, contain everything required to start your application. Just require. Don't wait. Not unrequired command, including dependency and configuration. Docker image create based on a Docker file. So you must create a Docker file to create your Docker image for your project. A Docker file is a list of instructions that define how to build and start your application. So the command .net, .net run, .net restore, .net boot, .net publish, you can put on a Docker file. Put on your Docker file and you don't need to run a .net command .net run restore and boot. You just need to run a Docker boot and Docker run on your production and on server and Docker file or image creation. The Docker is repeatable and consistent. It's an example for Docker file on my application. First part of a Docker file is the different base image. I use a base image from a Microsoft slash ASP.NET Core dashboard with tech 2.0. Your Docker file should only describe the step you create for your application. Remember that. And the Docker file is not a dependency. The next step, the Docker file, is different dependency the application requires to start. Defining the directory and how to download and configure the dependency. The work deal instruction defined, I use a slash app to work deal loop to where commands should be executed from. Okay. How to download configure the dependency? How command to download configure and dependency? Copy all chat. The dependency is file with extension chsproj and copy the anything name with extension chsproj to .slash and run .NET restore. .NET restore is a command for download anything dependency in your chsproj. It's example for dependency, Microsoft.NET SDK.web, package reference, Microsoft ASP.NET Core, all is the dependency. And if you run a .NET master, it's automatic to download your directory. and still execute the command similar to launching base. Similar to launching to run to launching it from the base command line to your CLI and or your console. And how to build is the command for to build. .NET publish means C, alias means old, and you copy result for .NET publish to set up slash out. And how to build a Docker, create a Docker image with on your command Docker build, you must define a friendly name and tag. The name should refer to the application, should refer the application. And the tag string commonly used a fetch number. The tag is make you easy to use. It's an example to build a Docker. Docker build means SP. I will try. And Docker build the name. But the name is maybe SP2 with T1. Oh yes. My new project. Okay. Here's the Docker file. And match them with your project name. SP2. Set. Okay. Then you must Yes. That's around a Docker that you have already built. Docker with a syntax. Docker run you. To port from Docker image I spare web to with type p1. It's your application run on Docker, and it's your application run only with .NET. And if you want to check your image with the command Docker image, and you want can view the application log using, you can use a command Docker log as log with your name Docker image, and you have now successfully got a .NET application as a Docker image. Any question?
Why do you .NET?
It's from my experience. It's my office. I use a .NET, but .NET is just built on Windows. And but I want to .NET is I want to build .NET in Linux. How? And I search and find this this tutorial. If there's another question, okay.
What server?
What?
What server is run? In case of server.
The server in the Docker, you mean?
Under Docker.
This application running in Docker. Docker image the Microsoft the Docker Microsoft image is based in Debian. Debian. So the Docker image Microsoft ASP.NET is based on Debian. But they have based on Windows Server too, but it only run in the Docker on Windows. So you can run Docker in Windows too, but with specific image for our Windows.
What
image
server in Docker?
Ah, you mean the engine for web server image?
Like
Excel?
About
IIS. Oh, IIS. What? Oh my god, apa? Excel. Like the easy use Excel with it.
If you use the Docker, you not just need IIS, no. You can run anything server, yes, like that. Because your application, .NET or PHP or other, it run on Docker.
Application
nah.
Is running on Docker.
running on Docker. Docker and Docker running on a server. Not your application running on your server. Not your application, Docker and server. For if IIS, you running a application and it's a IIS server. It is a .NET framework application and it's IIS server. But if Docker, Docker is running in the server, yes? Docker is running in